बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। टुडे आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू साइंस ऑफ ग्रेड 8 विद पीटीबी सिलेबस चैप्टर नंबर 5 एंड टॉपिक इज़ 5.2 केमिकल इक्वेशन। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज़ आ केमिकल इक्वेशन? केमिकल इक्वेशन इज़ एक्चुअली आर रिप्रेजेंटेशन of a chemical reaction. Representation of a chemical reaction in terms of symbols, formulas, etc. When we represent a chemical reaction in terms of symbols, formulas, then we called it as a chemical equation. Okay, in a chemical reaction there are two things. First one is reactants and products. The things taking part in a chemical reaction are called as reactants, and the things that are formed after a reaction that are called as products. Okay, reactants and products, both of them are separated by an arrow. We use an arrow to separate the reactants and the products. Reactants are always written towards the left hand side, and products are always written towards the right hand side. Both are separated by an arrow, and we use the symbol of plus between the reactants, and also use the sign of plus between the products if we have more than one reactant or more than two or three products. The arrowhead is always towards the products. Next we have some symbols to represent the physical states of matter. For example, we have a sign of S that is written as the small sized symbol beneath the reactant. For example, we have iron and we write a small symbol S here. This S stands for the solid state of matter. We use EQ as an aqueous state. This is used for the liquid state, and we have the G symbol that is used for the gaseous state. Okay, and these three symbols are written as the smallest sign beneath the formula. Here I am taking the example of sulfur. Sulfur reacting with oxygen and forming sulfur dioxide. Here I am representing the states of these things. Sulfur is represented as S. It means that sulfur is in solid form and oxygen is in gaseous form, and sulfur dioxide is also in the gaseous form. So solid sulfur is mixed with the gaseous oxygen and it forms gaseous sulfur dioxide. Here the sign S is representing the solid state of sulfur, G is representing the gaseous state of oxygen, and this G also representing the gaseous state of sulfur dioxide. Here S and O2, both these are reactants, and SO2, this is the product, that is our sulfur dioxide. Next, let's take the example of zinc that is reacting with sulfuric acid and it forms zinc sulfate with hydrogen. Here I am representing the physical states of matter. Zinc is in solid form reacting with aqueous sulfuric acid, and zinc sulfate is also in aqueous form, and hydrogen is in the gaseous form. Here zinc and sulfuric acid, both of them are the reactants, and this arrow is representing the chemical reaction. And here is zinc sulfate, that is in the aqueous form, and here is hydrogen, that is in the gaseous form. So zinc react with sulfuric acid, form zinc sulfate, and hydrogen gas is released in this reaction. So this was a chemical equation, representation of the chemical reaction, and also the formation of reactants and the products and their and representation of their physical states. That's all. Thank you.